The EU delegation led by the ambassador of the European Union to Uganda, Attilio Pacifici, today visited and held a meeting with the NRM officials at the party secretariat in Kampala. This engagement, which was a follow-up of the meeting they held towards elections last year, comes just after the government lifted a ban on Democratic Governance Facility, commonly known as DGF. Although the meeting was closed to the media, the director in charge of communications at the NRM secretariat, Emmanuel Dombo, explained that the delegation was happy about the lifting of the ban.
This meeting today has come after the president had announced the lifting of the DGF facility that has been under suspension. To us, which is pleasant to everybody, to the NRM, the government, but also to the EU delegation, which had raised concern in the past about the prolonged suspension.
They were, however, concerned about the governance issues in the country, especially claims of human rights abuses, although the Secretary General of the NRM party, Richard Todung, assured them that enforcement of human rights is with institutions of government, not the NRM as a party.
Of the human rights issues are with the institutions of government, and the government is required to comply both at international level but also at the local level.
The EU team also raised concerns over the high poverty levels among Ugandans and asked what the NRM government is doing about it. Meanwhile, several human rights bodies have today celebrated the lifting of the ban on the DGF, arguing that it's a renewed opportunity to fight human rights abuses.
Renewed hope and opportunity to cooperate between government and the DGF. This will be done in a spirit of constructive engagement, and that the funds will go to those who actually are doing the work and deserve to be given the support, so that at the end of the day we see meaningful outcomes.
Report by Juliet Namwaya for the news.